Well, a major shakeup in the political landscape tonight in the race for governor in 2014 as State Comptroller Peter Franchot makes a surprise announcement. 11 News reporter David Callis has been following the developments and joins us in the studio with more. David?
Stan, Maryland Comptroller Peter Franchot plans to run for re-election and not for governor. His internal polling reveals he's more well-known and well-liked than any other potential candidate currently mentioned in the race. And the results show he has particular strength in the Baltimore area. But what this poll doesn't reflect is whether voters would put him in the governor's office.
Relieved and looking forward, Maryland Comptroller Peter Franchot declared he's seeking re-election rather than making a run for governor in 2014.
It was a personal decision and struggled with it because obviously people want you to step up and bring the state back to the center on fiscal issues. I can contribute a lot as a comptroller.
Turning down an opportunity for a promotion may be a game changer.
It certainly makes a difference in the race of the unannounced announced candidate.
Governor Martin O'Malley is term limited. He has already thrown his support behind Lieutenant Governor Anthony Brown. No Maryland Lieutenant Governor has ever been elected to the higher office, though. Attorney General Doug Gansler has already raised a boatload of money. His resume includes criminal prosecutor, fraud buster, and environmentalist. Howard County Executive Ken Ullman is also unofficially in the race. Historically, county executives have fared well in the race for governor, but Ullman has the least visibility right now. Montgomery County Delegate Heather Mizier is well known in her district and has been making a name for herself in Annapolis on social issues, such as same-sex marriage, and on the environmental front by challenging fracking.
I think it strengthens Gansler's hand, it probably strengthens Brown's, and it comes somewhat at the expense of Ullman.
Many believe this will still be an extremely competitive race. This early unannounced field could grow. So whoever wins the primary will also have to focus on reuniting the Democratic Party as they take on the Republican challenger. That unannounced field includes former Democrat Blaine Young, who's now the Republican president of the Frederick County Board of Commissioners, Charles Lawler, who ran against Congressman Steny Hoyer, Harford County Executive David Craig, and former Lieutenant Governor Michael Steele.
I think David Craig is clearly the odds-on favorite. It's got to be his, if he chooses to run, it's got to be his nomination to lose.
Michael Steele, puzzling?
Very puzzling. Michael, I don't think, would have very much of a chance in the Republican primary. I don't think the party would warm to him. I'm not sure that he's a good sell among voters either.
Franchot's decision not to run for governor may help sharpen differences between the two parties. Now, Franchot has a reputation as a fiscal hawk. Conservative Democrats and a lot of Republicans like that about him. If, and a big if, things went his way and he won the primary, Republicans may be hard-pressed to make an issue out of his fiscal conservatism. Reporting live from the studio, David Collins, WBAL-TV 11 News.